Welcome back to Ozarks Fox AM. Now we're joined by Dr. Mike Haney, who is the founder and executive director of the Institute for Veterans and Military Families. Mike, first of all, I want to thank you. You are an Air Force veteran. We want to thank you for your service. And obviously, you felt there was a huge need to start this organization. So how does this help veterans and their families?
Well, thanks so much for having me. I am an Air Force veteran, and that's, I think, part of the story. When I got out of the Air Force and came to Syracuse University as a professor, I really saw an opportunity to create an academic institute focused on the social, economic, the wellness concerns of veterans and their families, and do it in an actionable way. That is an institute that runs programs and offers services to help military members navigate that transition to civilian life, whether it's a transition to a job and a career, or to business ownership, or to higher education. So today we run programs all over the United States with that end in mind, really helping service members, military-connected family members, navigate that transition to civilian life.
Very good. I'm sitting with my co-host, Clay Cooper. He's a big fan of the veterans as well, and he has a show in Branson where he does something special for the veterans. I think it's really important what you are doing here. Obviously, as yourself as a veteran, knew what to do for the families. These programs, how can people get involved in these programs?
Yeah, the easiest way to learn about the programs that we run, whether they will benefit you directly as a veteran, or if you want to support that effort, is to go to our website. The website is ivmf.syracuse.edu, and at that website you can learn about the various programs, which, by the way, are all offered without any charge whatsoever. They're all free to veterans and military spouses. And you can also find out how to support those programs at the website.
That's awesome. You know, that is an issue. I mean, I've heard for many times. I do a lot of work in Branson with veterans. We do veteran shows during Veterans Week and help raise money and you know, put on concerts for the vets. And I talk and meet with a lot of veterans, and they all say that transition going from, you know, being in the service or being in active wartime, and then coming back here, all of a sudden you're out there in the elements, you're fighting, you're trying to stay alive, and then bam, one day you're dropped back in the real world, and it's not an easy transition. I mean, is that correct?
Yeah, that is absolutely right. And I think more so even today, you know, if you think about the fact that, you know, today the United States' model of military service is a volunteer military. And a consequence of that is only a tiny segment of our population has that today, that shared experience of military service. So if you think about, you know, someone who served and now transitions back to their hometown, et cetera, they may be hard pressed to find a sense of community and someone or other people who understand and have that same shared experience. So it does create some isolation, you know, some social isolation. I think the extent to which we can build community around these men and women as they transition out of the military will make all the difference in the world.
I think that's an important thing you were talking about. I think we, as people who have not served, need to be educated, because we don't understand what these veterans have gone through. So when you're dealing with families, that helps the whole family to kind of be in on the whole, you know, program.
Yeah.
Yep, absolutely. Could not have said it better. You know, if you think about a military family, you know, on average, a military family picks up and moves every 3 years. Mm-hmm. So when they finally make the decision to transition out of the military, that last move, this is the community that they want to be in and connect to, you know, now not for just 3 years, but for the next 20 years. And to the extent to which those communities can really wrap their arms around those families and embrace them in a culturally competent way, in a way that there is some level of understanding of what that military service experience was for that family, is really positioned to have a positive impact.
Do the families kind of come together, some of the different families, do they all meet together and kind of get to know each other in a community situation?
Yeah, I think that's important. And I think it's important, though, that it's not just military families, that
right.
it's broadly members of that community, so that, because the last thing we want to do is sort of silo off our military-connected families outside of the larger community.
Okay, we've got a video to show here. You're doing some construction work. You're doing some updating.
Yeah, so we're exciting times for the effort. We announced a few years ago the construction of something we're calling the National Veterans Resource Center. It's a first of its kind facility in all of higher education, really created specifically as a national center of excellence in the education space, focused on veterans and their families. And you know, we hope that through this center, we can bring other colleges, universities, corporations, private sector employers to our mission and really grow that mission two, three, fourfold what it is today.
That's a beautiful building,
that
isn't it?
That is awesome.
And that's absolutely in Syracuse?
That's right on the campus of Syracuse University.
Yeah. Now, how can local people join in and be part of your programs again?
Yeah, again, the website, ivmf.syracuse.edu, veterans in your community, service members in your community can enroll in the programs that we offer right through that website. And there's also information about volunteering to be a mentor for a veteran who might be looking to start a business or get into an industry that you're already in. So lots of ways to plug into the mission right through the website.
All right, Mike Haney, thank you so much for joining us today and for your mission and what you're doing, and also happy Veterans Day to you.
Thank you for your service, sir.
Thank you for your service.
Thank you so much for having me.
Okay.
All right, we'll be right back with some record time. Don't you go anywhere.
I don't think there's much country in there today.
Spin that record.
You know him.